Welcome to a video on the integral test for convergence of an infinite series. The integral test states that if f of x is a positive decreasing continuous function on the interval from 1 to infinity such that f of n is equal to a sub n, meaning when the input into the function is n equals the formula to generate the terms in the series, then if the integral on the interval from 1 to infinity converges, then so does the infinite series. And if the integral diverges, then the infinite series also diverges. A couple other quick notes here. The interval does not necessarily have to start at 1, and the function does not necessarily need to be decreasing. It just needs to be decreasing for some x value larger than 1. So we're not going to prove this test here, but here's the idea. If we consider the harmonic series and the function y equals 1 over x, the integral test states that if we can determine the area under the function and above the x-axis on the interval from 1 to infinity, as we see here, then this infinite series will be convergent. And if this improper integral is divergent, then so is the infinite series. Let's take a closer look at this harmonic series. Now, it's always a good idea to apply the nth term divergent test before we start, which means if we take the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n, which is 1 over n in this case, if this doesn't equal 0, then this would diverge. And notice this limit is equal to 0. So it does pass the nth term divergent test, which, remember, does not guarantee this will converge. It just tells us that it does pass the nth term divergent test. So we do have to apply a different test to determine if it does converge. So if we want to apply the integral test, we're going to let f of x equal 1 over x, since f of n will equal a sub n. So now we'll find the integral from 1 to infinity of 1 over x with respects to x. If this converges, so does the series. If it diverges, so does the series. This is an improper integral, so we'll state this is equal to the limit as b approaches infinity of the integral from 1 to b of 1 over x with respects to x. This is going to give us the limit as b approaches infinity of natural log x. Now we'll go ahead and replace x with b and then x with 1. So we'll have the limit as b approaches infinity of natural log b minus natural log 1. Well, as b approaches infinity, so does natural log b, and natural log 1 is equal to 0. So this would be equal to infinity, which does not exist. So this tells us the integral diverges, and therefore so does the harmonic series based upon the integral test. Before we take a look at the next example, remember this would be 1 over n to the first power. The reason I wanted to point that out is now we'll take a look at the series generated by 1 over n to the power of 1.1. So the exponent on n is just a little bit larger. Let's see what happens in this case. We'll let f of x equal 1 over x to the 1.1 power. And this function is positive, decreasing, and continuous on the given interval. So let's go ahead and try to determine if the improper integral diverges or converges. I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this as x to the negative 1.1. Since this is an improper integral, we'll take the limit as b approaches infinity of the integral from 1 to b. So we'll add 1 to the exponent. That'll give us x to the negative 0.1 all over negative 0.1. I'm going to evaluate this at b and 1. Before we do this, I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this in a different way. This would be x to the negative 1/10 power, and this would be negative 1/10 in the denominator. So let's rewrite this one more time before we find the limit. Dividing by negative 1/10 is the same as multiplying by negative 10, so we'll have negative 10. Then I'm going to move this down to the denominator, so it'll be x to the power of 1/10. Now we'll go ahead and replace x with b and x with 1. So we'll have negative 10 over b to the 1/10 minus negative 10 over 1 to the 1/10. As b approaches infinity, this approaches 0, and this is not affected by b, so this would just be positive 10 over 1, which is just 10. Notice this improper integral does converge, and therefore so does this infinite series, based upon the integral test. Notice if this exponent on n is just a little bit larger than 1, it converges, but on the previous example, when n is equal to 1, it diverges. And we'll come back to this idea in the next video when we discuss the p-series test. Let's go and take a look at one more problem using the integral test, and this one's going to be a little bit more involved. So we'll let f of x equal natural log x divided by x squared, which again is continuous, decreasing, and positive on the interval. So we'll set up our improper integral from 1 to infinity of natural log x, and I'm going to rewrite this as x to the negative 2 dx. Now the reason I'm going to do that is we're going to have to integrate this using integration by parts. Remember, integration by parts states that u dv is equal to uv minus the integral of v du. So if we let u equal natural log x, that means dv is going to have to be x to the negative 2 dx. So if u is natural log x, then du is going to equal 1 over x dx. And to find v, we'll have to integrate this, so we'll add 1 to the exponent. That'll be x to the negative 1 divided by negative 1. So that'll be negative 1 over x. So we'll have the limit as b approaches infinity of u times v, which will be negative natural log x over x, minus the integral from 1 to b of v du. Well, here's v and here's du, so we're going to have negative 1 over x squared dx. This is going to become plus, and instead of writing 1 over x squared, I'll write x to the negative 2 dx. Let's go ahead and find this antiderivative. Well, if we add 1 to the exponent, that'd be x to the negative 1 divided by negative 1, so we'll have negative 1 over x. Let's go ahead and replace x with b and then x with 1, and then determine this limit. So we'll have negative natural log b over b minus 1 over b minus negative natural log 1 over 1 minus 1 over 1. Now, to determine this limit, as b approaches infinity, we'd have to apply L'Hopital's rule to this fraction, which would give us negative 1 over b over 1. So this approaches 0. This approaches 0 as b approaches infinity. Natural log 1 is equal to 0, so this is 0. And this is not affected by b. So we have minus negative 1. So this limit is equal to 1. Therefore, we can state that this infinite series converges. And that's going to do it for this video. Next, we'll take a look at the P-series test. I hope you found this video helpful.